click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will study overloading of binary operators. In the last video, we have discussed with how to overload unary operator. Now we will go on to the next topic, that is binary operator overloading. Now suppose if I have two complex numbers, if my first complex number is 2.3 plus 6.4 and my second complex number is 4.3 plus 6.1. Suppose if I want to perform the addition of these two complex numbers, then how my addition is going to be 6.4 plus 6.1, first I will add this part, then this part, and the answer which will come, that I will store inside the third variable, that is C3. So now see how to, this is an example of binary operator overloading. Why we called it as binary operator? Because this operator is with the two operands, so I called it as what? Binary operators. Now we will discuss how to overload binary operators. Now see this program. This program is to perform addition of two complex numbers. As I have already explained, I have taken these two complex numbers and C3 is going to be the addition of these two complex numbers. So complex number always consists of two parts. The first part is called as real part, whereas second part is called as imaginary part. So let us consider X as a real part and Y as a imaginary part. So I will call it as what? Complex number. Now see here what I have done. I have declared two variables X and Y. So these are the two variables X and Y, and these are two, yes, constructor. This constructor is called as zero argument constructor. This constructor is two argument constructor, where I am initializing the value of X as a real and Y as a imaginary. Then this is the syntax of what? Yes, operator overloading. So complex operator plus complex. So it means what? I am overloading here which operator? Plus operator I am overloading. Void show is a function which is used to display the addition of two complex number. Now see here, this is the very important part, how to perform addition of these two complex numbers is given in this part. Now see here, as we have three complex numbers, so it means we have to create three objects. That is, as I have already explained, suppose my objects are C1, C2 and C3, whereas C is my first complex number, C2 is my second complex number, and C3 is going to be the addition of C1 plus C2. Now see here, whenever I have more than one objects, then I can use one object as it is, but for the remaining two objects, I need to call those objects, or I need to access those objects using creating their objects. See, you don't get confused. I will explain you here what I have done. My two numbers are C1 and C2. So it is like 2.3 plus 6.4 and 4.3 plus 6.1. So this is the X part and this is the Y part, whereas this is going to be my answer. Now see, this is my C1, this is my C2, and this is the C1 ka X part, this is the C2 ka X part, and where after adding this I will get a C3 X part. It means one object I can use as it is. It means I will be calling C1 as it is, but for C2 and C3 I have to create their objects. So for C2 I have created object C, whereas for C3 I have created object temp. So C3 is going to be what? Addition. So that's why I've created object temp here, and C2's object is C. So while accessing these complex numbers, I will be doing something like this. I will be adding C1's X part with C2's X part, and I am going to get C3's X part. I will be adding C1's X part with C2's X part, and I will get C3's X part. See, but C1's X part I can use as it is, but for the C2's X part I have to create an object, and that object I have created, that is C. So while accessing C2's X part, I will be writing something like this, C2.x. So for C3's object, I have created an object, for C3's object, I have created an object, that is temp. So I will be writing something like this, temp.x is equal to x plus c.x. So see here, that's what I have already written here. Again for the y part, I will be doing the same procedure. C1's y I can use as it is, but for c2's y I have created an object, that is c. So c.y, and the addition of this two is going to be a c3's y, and for c3's y we have created one more object, that is temp. So it means only C1's object I use as it is, but for C2 and C3 I created an object. For C2 I created object that is C, and for C3 I created object that is tip. So this is how I perform addition of complex numbers. Now see here, then I am displaying the addition of this by using the show function. So cout x and cout y. So here what I am displaying, I am just displaying my answer. This is the main function. In the main function, I have created three objects, C1, C2, C3. C1 I have initialized as 2.3 and 6.4. C2 I have initialized as 4.3 and 6.1. Then the addition of C3 is C1 plus C2. Then I am displaying my first complex number. Then I am displaying my second complex number. And then addition of these two complex numbers. So I hope you have understood how to overload binary operators. Whenever we overload binary operators, the rule says the one operator with one object we can use as it is, but for the remaining object we create their object. Now see, I have one more example. Suppose if I am performing addition and division of two ratios. Now see here, I have declared two variables, that is numerator and denominator. My numerator is going to be a x and denominator is going to be a y. And what I am doing here, I am overloading two operators. They are plus operator and division operator. So I have, it means two numbers, two ratios I can say, my R1 and R2. My R1 is nothing but numerator upon denominator, and again R2 is nothing but numerator upon denominator, and the addition of R1 plus R2, whatever will come, that will be R3. So let us write this. R3 is equal to R1 plus R2. So for R1, I have a number numerator upon denominator. Suppose again R2 is numerator upon denominator, and R3 is numerator upon denominator. Now R1, as we have already studied, R1 we can use as it is, but for R2 and R3 we need to create their objects. So for R2 I have created an object that is x. So x is an object to access the R2, and temp is an object to access the R3. So while performing addition of this, how will I write? For R3, temp is going to be an object. So temp dot numerator is equal to, see, whenever I perform addition of two ratios, how it is, it will be a cross multiplication. So numerator into the denominator, I cannot write as it is, I have to use this denominator along with the x. So numerator into x dot denominator plus, again this will be denominator into x dot numerator. So denominator into x dot numerator. If you will see this line, that's what exactly I have got. Temp dot numerator is equal to numerator into x dot denominator plus x dot numerator into denominator. Again for the denominator, what I will do, denominator will be temp dot denominator is equal to denominator into x dot denominator. So see, that's what I have already got here. So this is how I perform addition or division of binary operators. Whenever you overload binary operators, at that time one object we can treat as it is, but for the remaining object we create their object. I mean the remaining object will be accessed by using the objects of the relevant class. That is, R2 is accessed by x and R3 is accessed by temp. So I hope you have understood how to overload and binary operators. Thanks for watching this video. For the more videos, please subscribe the channel eKida.